Guess who's hitting quicksave? Because this looks suspiciously like a boss chamber. No, I don't want to die horribly. Ooh. More of that. Okay. I hope this isn't a boss chamber because I have not found a pitch. Get out of the way of the fire really quick. What the fuck is going on in here? Hello, friend?
Oh, hello.
Anything over here? No. Careful. Looking for secrets or things to interact with. Might just be a crazy fire room. That just might be what, you know, gets these guys off. Let's see, over there there's a pressure plate, but it's behind two gates, so I can't even interact with it from here. We'll just get out of here. Oh, I found an item. Oh god, how do you get it though? Guess who's taking a hit? Okay, Meteor leg plate. Ooh, that's a good upgrade. That's better than crystal, right? 15 protection, 5 health. 18 protection. Yeah, I'll take the 18 protection. More meteor for my character, which means this guy gets crystal instead of his dumb plate. And I'll just carry the plate back to the hub so I can keep it in my stash so I can feel good about my crazy collection of items. But there we go. Second meteor piece. Now I'm wearing 3 pieces of meteor. I have 2 to go. And I found 1, 2... Let's see. I have 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces of meteor and 1, 2... Yeah, 1, 2, 3 pieces of crystal on me right now. So I'm definitely getting a lot of both sets. I'm a little surprised that this place would have a piece of meteor. Just because I've been writing it off as a low level area because I haven't been finding a lot of upgrades. Although I'm currently using a weapon from here, so I guess maybe that's not the way to. Then maybe that's not entirely true. But just feels like a low level area kind of. It looks like there's some, yeah, getting multiple of these gems. Oh, here we go, there's the tomb. Mystery solved there, I suppose. I'm getting these crystal flowers, and so naturally I want to craft some stat bonus potions, since I'm getting some surplus of these, but I can't until I get the guy back alive. Where was the... There's a healing crystal just right downstairs. I think I'm gonna have to go downstairs and heal, just because if anything... I don't know. Let's power on for a little bit. Worst case scenario, I just have to load my autosave if I die horribly. But maybe they'll be nice enough to just give me a healing gem up here? Maybe? So I don't want to go all the way back to the power crystal right now to heal. We're getting more and more cannonballs. Wow. If we fight a big fought... Okay, so the master of the island was lording over everybody and creating golems and shit to do manual labor. They created a symbol, and it's... Oh! They created the pyramid for him, and then he locked everyone in, and they died in here. So there was an indigenous people that the master of the island enslaved, and they seemed to worship him and work for him, but then he locked them all in here to die. And then they made pictures about it, I guess. Betrayal. Yep, that sure is what happened. Oh, cool, I can open the opposite door with this rock. Goodbye, rock. Goodbye forever. This is where you live now. Anything gonna attack me now that I press that? No? Okay, let's go to the fire room. And backtrack around. Ooh, another gem. I mean, another beautiful flower of awesome skill pointness. I'm getting so many in here. I'm cool with that. Okay. Pressure plate. I'll go get that. I'll go deal with the rock, what I just did with the rock in a second. I just wanna see what's in here. Even more ammo, wow. I probably should just be using my gun, I guess, with this character. I've been trying to conserve ammo for when I need it, but if I have 150 shots, I guess maybe I don't need to conserve so bad anymore. Scroll of Dark Bolt. Our Dark Bolt scroll. That's not the scroll. Where's Dark Bolt scroll? There it is. It's a utility spell. Shoots a ray that engulfs the target in magical darkness. Let's try it. Good. Oh. Accidentally cast balance for a moment there, now we have to wait. It's a bummer that as far as I know, you can't cancel the spell cast that you started accidentally doing. Grung, Dark Bolt. Shoots a ray that engulfs the target in a magical darkness. And it says utility spell, that's curious. It requires concentration 3, which I just happened to learn, like, basically minutes ago. So that's convenient, I guess. There's another door over here. Oh, it's already open. Ooh, okay. We get grass. Arrival. Let's go look at the painting. The indigenous people came here. Oh, they were called here by the island. Like some lost shit is basically what's going on here. They were called here by the Island Master. Yep. Island Master called them here, and then he enslaved them to build this pyramid. And then he killed them by locking them in here. Huntsman Cloak. That's probably good for my ranged character, right? Evasion, Dexterity, Vitality. That actually might be good for my... this guy. Vitality and Resist Cold versus Evasion, Dexterity, and yeah. This gives me dexterity for my dexterity weapon to do more damage. Boom. Give me more vitality to heal, to live longer, and evasion to be resistant. And this one just gives me resist cold, which is less cool. Especially since cold does not seem to be a frequent threat. I think there was... Oh yeah, my primary problem with cold was when I fought those ice monsters in the ruins of Desaroon. But that's behind me now, and I have not countered them in so long that I don't know if they're even a thing anymore. So I guess we have to go back to that fire chamber. And that's the next thing to do, because everything in here is pretty much solved, aside from obviously... Just in case someone's yelling at me again. obviously I need to go put those keys in the statue, but I want to get all the extra stuff first. The gear necklace, that sounds like something cool, right? 15 health and energy. That's not terrible. But this one gives me makes me immune to starvation and burden, which helps me carry shit around, which is nice. This gives me immunity. I'm just making up words today. It makes me not be affected by basically any special conditions. So that's, and I actually like having that. This one makes me get more experience, and this one makes me resist cold. Huh. Health and energy might be better than some of this stuff. Here. What if I give the health and energy... Let's see. Immunity to stuff. Let's do some rearranging. This guy's been leveling up for a while, and I actually have less things I'm psyched about leveling him with right now, so... We give the experience points to... Should we give the experience points to Lizardman? Let's give Lizardman the experience points. I just tried to put it on the character in totally the wrong way. Resist cold, I'm less excited about. Okay, we'll give the health and energy to our lead guy to make him live longer and hit people harder. And we'll give our immunity to conditions to... Mixed up here. No, maybe... No. We'll keep immunity conditions on him. I think we'll give health and energy to our spellcaster. Because he could do with living a little longer, right? A little more hit points to keep him alive, and a little more energy to help him spellcast. That's good. As opposed to willpower. I think 15 energy is more than what you get from willpower, although willpower might also make you more powerful in spells, huh? Regeneration rate, points in how much energy you have, cold resistance. Huh, okay. I'm fine with just leaving how it is, I think. I think I'm more or less happy with the change. I don't need this resist cold item as much as I could use just some basic stats. I'm pretty much ready to leave this place though, so maybe this is the last floor, because I wouldn't mind going back to the hub and dumping off some of my cool stuff, because I don't want to just drop it on the ground. I almost walked directly into that fire. Careful, 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 careful. There we go. So we're back in this chamber, and I'm not psyched by the fact that I'm still paralyzed, because I feel like when I... You know what, guys? Just to be safe, I'm going to backtrack and get my actually, he's just petrified, right? Let's see, I have a shitty healing potion somewhere, right? Yeah, I do. Okay, let's give him the shitty healing potion. Maybe that'll fix him. Nope, that doesn't fix him. Okay, I'm going to go all the way back. I'm going to go all the way back to that gem to regenerate my character. Because this looks like a big, crazy chamber where there might be a boss fight. And if that happens when I put the keys in, I don't want my character to be petrified. So we'll be right back. Alrighty, everyone's in ship shape, and I've done my quick save, so now let's find out what happens when I put these tomb keys in. Just how screwed I might be. Okay. Oh, teleporter's unleashing mummies on us. Let's get rid of those right away. Bye, mummies. Oh, there's more mummies. So many mummies. Joke's on you, game. I'm not even afraid of mummies. They're hardly even threatening. Gunshots and stuff. That's a lot of mummies. That is actually a significant quantity of mummies. Still probably not very threatening. Just line them all up and throw a bunch of fire at them. Please regenerate your attack. There we go. Mummies die! Yeah, this is not as threatening as it's probably intended to be, because I'm just I am too high level for this trap. I am quite ready. I actually feel bad now, though, because now we've established that all the mummies attacking us are the people who built this place, and they were tricked and enslaved and betrayed by the island master, who is... We now have extra reason to think as a dick. So now we've established the island master calls people to this island and traps them, and then just kind of fucks with them, presumably for fun. Because up until now, you might have thought that we just got here, by unfortunate coincidence, but he specifically called us here, and now he's just fucking with us for his amusement, and that is not okay. So let's figure out where this teleporter goes. What the f- Oh my fucking god. Holy- I've never seen so much shit happen ever. I've never seen so much shit. Okay. So the good news is, I'm not in danger, I don't think. Because even if they trap me, I can just fight my way out. Like this. Ka-tong, ka-tong. There we go. So I guess let's just explore and see what kind of cool stuff we can find here. Holy crap, though. I didn't know this game could even handle that kind of crazy shit. Serpent Blade, that is a dex weapon? Oh, light weapons, 5. 13 to 39 dex. Yes. Accuracy plus 15. I just found the best dex weapon ever. Awesome. But I need to get 5 dex. Oh, cool. One more level and I have light weapons 5, so I'm fine. I'll have that soon anyway. So that's a cool item to find. Dear Lord, you could just hang out here and farm so much crazy experience, couldn't you? God damn. Oh god, what is that? Oh god, the giant... oh god. Okay, that's bad. Okay, this is becoming a problem. There's a quantity of dudes here. Dear Lord, do I have to fight all these guys? I mean, I can. They're not very strong. Especially if I can find a healing location, like a crystal. I could probably hang out here and fight them all day. But, I'm a little concerned. Here, I'll hang out off here in the distance. Because at least over here, I won't get overwhelmed. Because only nearby ones will kind of aggro on me, I think. They are really just kind of wandering around. So the mummies are not a threat. But off in the distance, you can see massive, crazy golem monsters like the ones we saw in that painting. And that is a threat. That could really screw me up, couldn't it? Hey, guys. Oh, did not have enough energy for that. My bad. Do I have enough for this? Yes, I do. Let's just ruin some people's days. How much experience do I get from these guys? 90? I could actually get enough experience here to use my new dex weapon. Especially since right now they're kind of just funneling in one at a time. Oh, they're trapping me. Trapping me, trapping me, trapping me. It's not good to be trapped. Please die. I'm missing. Shit. And I'm out of energy. Let's recover some energy real quick and blow them the fuck up. Here. 90 energy at a time. How long is that going to take for me to level up? I need about 700 experience. So that's like 8 kills, basically. So some crowds of that are like this big will actually help. I don't have enough energy for that. Fucking use a big potion, I guess. Flurry of fire. How's that for experience, motherfucker? Jesus. Okay, I'm getting a little concerned about the number of them now. They're just gonna keep coming. They don't really do damage, though, do they? Yeah, they really are only a threat to my back row because it's hard to face the proper direction to not get attacked because there's not really a one-way hallway I can hide in and just wait for them all to come. So right now, the biggest threat is the fact that they can get behind me relatively easily. Fucking blast you away! So the most efficient way to deal with these guys is probably going to be fire spells. So what I can do is I can give this guy the mortar and pestle. There we go. I was having trouble there. So I should just craft some freaking healing potions here. I'm just casually standing here. Don't worry, guys. It's cool. They only do one damage at a time. I'm just going to sit here and craft a bunch of healing potions. Mana potions. Da-da-da-da-da. Okay. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Then recover mana. And I can just blow all these fucking mummies away. Let's just deal with this guy. Just one guy on his own. Hit. Kung. That didn't quite work. Okay. Is that golem heading here? That golem might be heading here. That golem is totally heading here. This is becoming a threat. I'm gonna quick save. Oh god, shoot a fireball at me right now. Jesus, I just got out of that. So, apparently the golem shoots a crazy AoE, like, plus sign of fire. But those golems are genuinely threatening, in a way that the mummies are not. Oh god, he trapped me. He trapped me and I'm gonna get hit. Oh, oh wow, if you rotate, the fireballs actually rotate with you and fire in that direction. Okay. That guy's huge. I don't want it. Oh god, he's about to trap me. Please die. Please die. Uh-oh. That was very... Okay. That's not good. Let's move. Let's just get out in the middle of the place and just run across the middle. Do a little bit of exploring. Get away from the golem for a bit. Become aware of any other potential cool secrets around here. Oh, there's a potion over there. Let's go find that. I'm just happy to go anywhere besides where I am right now. Those guys are on their own. They're easy to kill. Ching! Oh, he didn't die. There we go. You're not leveled yet? Oh, I need 6,000 experience. Shit. It's gonna take me like 50 billion mummies to get that much experience. Oh, hey, I found my dead end. And Plate Greaves. Really? Just now I'm finding Plate Greaves, the, like, most useless thing ever? Whatever, I'll pick it up just because, I guess. So, if this place was all mummies all the time, all day, then I could hide here. And I could stand here, and I could fight, and I could kill every single mummy here by, just standing here and wiping them all out one by one. Because from the front, they're not dangerous. But if I'm realizing if I stand here, I'm very much at risk of the, goddamn, they're all coming in now. There's a very real risk here that I will get trapped by the golem, who is actually a credible threat. I'm just gonna keep making more healing potions for my... I mean, more, mana potions. There we go. You have a bunch of mana? You have 10 big mana potions now. Neato. Let's give your bolts back now. Because my most efficient way of dealing with these enemies is to just do my crazy flurry of fireballs. And the best way to do that is just to blow people out of the fucking sky. Hey guys. Bye. There we go. That's a nice little chunk of experience. Here comes big guy though. I do... How much damage did I do to him? I couldn't even see. Bye. He's like a crazy spin attack, which I do not want to even find out how much damage that does. Oh guys, this is a dead end. It's maybe a dead end. Oh no, it's not a dead end. There's an exit behind this guy. Okay. Statue says... You have been misled. Not everything is composed of four sides. Six is the most powerful figure. What, is this game gonna suddenly become six-sided? Oh god, this cloak just trapped me. Protection plus five. I'll deal with this cloak later. Let's just give it on... whose inventory am I in right now? Cloak, go to guy that can fucking carry it. Who can carry it? There, you can carry it. Okay. Right now I just want to grab things and run, so I don't want to get trapped in here. Oh, there's one of these guys. Hey buddy. Die. Where's the golem? The golem looked kind of big. I don't know. Can he fit through those areas? So far, I've never encountered a Grimrock enemy that doesn't fit in a square. So, but I wouldn't put them past them to introduce something like that. That'd be kind of cool, actually. There's a stump. Those usually have notes in them, but I don't see one this time. We have more ammo. Let's grab that really quick, and hopefully, it doesn't overencumber me. Yay! You didn't screw me this time. We're making progress at exploring it. I don't like that I left kind of a stump there, so let's go over there. There's like one little... okay, I kind of trapped myself. No golems around, though. Okay. You get fucking flurry of stuff. There we go. Is this map filled in? Map's filled in. Let's just turn around. Oh god, I'm just gonna be here for 500 years fighting these guys, aren't I? Oh god. I mean, this is by far the most things I've seen ever in a thing, period, in this game. Where's the mummy? Okay. Wow, even the big healing potion, even the big mana potions don't actually... Oh, that was a waste of mana. I did way too powerful of a spell that was not gonna get caught by enemies necessarily. There we go. Much better. Did I even drop anything? Okay, this way. Have not gone this way yet. Hey guys. Die. That was really effective. And die. Die. Wow, another one. Okay. There's so many enemies around here that I actually am just actively blowing through all of my mana. Oh, healing crystal. Checkpoint that I can use to recover periodically. And another stat potion item. Should I just craft more stats? I could get my tank more dexterity, I guess. Why not? Shall be fine. More dexterity for my tank, dude. Especially since he's about to get a weapon that makes him better with offensively with dex. Who's there? It's just one of you guys. That's fine. Get out of here. Ding ding. Now he's got 20 dexterity. That's cool. And 30 accuracy. So maybe you'll stop fucking missing all the time. Hey, buddy. Get out of here. Du-du-du-du-du-du-dum. I gotta say, I've done that like 12 times now. Still not any less satisfying, actually. doing the ridiculous flurry of fire that wipes out an entire row of the mummies is actually really fun to do. I'm really glad I have meteor shower. And I've only really got it because of this stuff. Oh, Jesus, I just leveled up. I actually finally killed enough to level up. Okay. No. No, clear. Shit, I almost did athletics. There we go. Light weapons, too. Now I can get that light weapon. Man, what if I dual wield? That could actually be fun, right? Let's see. Having light weapons 5. You can now dual wield any light weapons. When dual wielding, you suffer 40% penalty to weapon damage. It might be fun to dual wield. I don't know. I'll keep my shield around. Originally this was meant to be my tank, so I didn't dual wield really. But then my Minotaur got heavy armor now too, so now the concept of a tank is mostly just relative. So conceivably, I could be like blam blam and just like wrecking people all day. It might be fun to dual wield on my ex tank now that tankiness is less exclusive to him, and I could just deal damage. Wow, they're still throwing fire at me. That's not exciting to me. Hey guys, get out of my way. There we go. Oh wow, it still hit the guys all the way over there. Alright. Ching ching. Bloom. 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 Wow, wow, wow. So many melee attacks. Just a flurry of blows. That's actually pretty cool. Wow, so now I'm like realizing his destiny as a light weapon attack spammer. Which means I can actually relatively effectively kill people here without having to use magic the whole time. We're about to get pinned in here. There's a teleporter, which I assume is how I leave. But I don't want to leave until I've fully explored this area to my satisfaction, because there could be other cool shit around here. Oh, cool, Slick gained a level. The way to ascension leads through the hidden fifth shrine. Okay, we have another clue about the existence of a fifth shrine. Golems are coming still. Okay, let's move on. Let's move on, class. We're intruding upon the people stuffs. How does backstabbing work is what I want to check. I think this game has a light weapon backstab, right? And the fact that I'm using light weapons means that I can backstab when I'm behind someone, I assume? I don't necessarily know how it works. Do I trigger it manually, or does it just happen on its own? Like, it's just a bonus chance thing? Does that not have a special effect? Oh, it doesn't have a special effect. Okay. The Serpent Blade has no special effect. But it's definitely a fun weapon to use. Okay. So the Serpent Blade is a more powerful weapon, but it has no special effect, so I'm just gonna click that one, but I can manually charge my hand dagger. What's out in the middle there? There's a few items out in the middle there to go after. Let's just go for it. Hut. Hut. And hut. Hut. It's mostly items for my, gun user to carry, too. More ammo. Please don't get over-encumbered. What do we have around here? We're pretty much... I haven't fully explored the entire map as far as filling in the grid, but it's looking like I've more or less got everything. I'm trying to still keep moving because I don't trust myself to be able to fight one of those golems. It feels like you might be expected to run away from them. Let's see. Man, there were certainly a lot more mummies here when I first got here, huh? I have made headway for sure. Hopefully I can come back. Oh, well, of course I can come back here. There's a teleporter at the top of the pyramid. I think, I may go ahead and just kill all the mummies off camera. I might come back and kill all the mummies later, just for the experience. But this is the six-sided thing. Not everything's coded 4-sided. 6 is the most powerful figure. Yeah, okay. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna say I'm done here, guys. So, I'm going to go to the teleporter to hopefully leave. Because otherwise, I'm just gonna eventually get caught by those golems. And I think it's entirely possible they might be able to kill me. Although, oh god. I don't like them at all. There's a good chance I'll come back later and fight the golems again. But for now, I just want to get a more secure feeling of where I am, and that I'm safe, and that I've finished the pyramid to some extent. Okay, in we go. We are... Is this somewhere new? Oh no, is this just a place I've been before? The Silent One has a friend who is willing to speak. Head towards the sunrise beyond the gate to find him. The Silent One. Okay. The Silent One is over there-ish, so I'm supposed to go... supposed to go forward for a while to figure out what he wants. But anyway, now we have this teleporter. Which takes you to this crazy desert. So we'll definitely mark that for, oopsie. So that is the mummy teleport... Oh, mummy desert teleporter. So that was a surprise. We got important... We actually got some important story lore type stuff discovered here. I don't necessarily know how to get to that elemental shrine still, unfortunately, but at least we figured out the mummy stuff. I think we pretty much... I believe we've completed the, we've more or less completed this pyramid. And that's it, really. So I have cool new loot to have. I'm gonna go put stuff in my stash, I think. Just to free up my inventory. But then I think next episode, unless people point out something really important that I need to backtrack and find, I think I'm gonna go over here on this path I still haven't gone down on the right. Because that's the cemetery. I set foot in it for one brief moment because I thought it was something else and I messed up, but I went back. So that's the cemetery. We'll be going there next, I think. There's the barren desert. And now, we're getting more and more information. We have that three-part clue that I got a long time ago. There we go. The frozen tundras, the sun was setting, hot desert, Star of the North, all that stuff. Well, we have a desert up top. So maybe, let's see, I haven't found a frozen tundra yet. But obviously north is always in the same direction. So maybe when we go through the cemetery, we'll find a frozen area somewhere around here. And then we'll have clues that'll actually give us better information about how the hell we use these puzzles, these little clues. And then I'll be happy to leave them behind. Let's see, let's level up Mr. Slick by giving him points and something. His accuracy is pretty good, actually, at this point. He tends to hit, so I'm not super concerned about that. I might just give him hit points? Hit points don't seem like a bad idea. Or light armor. Huh. Light armor would not be a terrible idea, so he could take more hits. Because I definitely get a lot of light armor around. But he does have the... No. I want to give him the rogue... No, even then, the rogue set isn't even good for him. Because the dexterity doesn't really help him. Because dexterity doesn't affect guns. So maybe I will invest. Yeah, I think I'll go towards light armor. Or hit points. No. It's easier to get to light armor because it's only 2 points. So I'll level him up a bit so he can wear light armor. And he can inherit all that light armor that my other characters used to wear. And he'll get more powerful that way. Alright. Thanks for watching, guys. This is probably the end of the episode unless something ambushes me on the way back to the hub, which has happened before. But I'm just going to go and try to stash all my new cool loot. And then I'll see you guys when I go to the cemetery, / when I try to clean up based on comments you guys made and get something I missed. Thanks for watching, like always. You know, encourage me with a like if you want, or mostly I just like talking to you guys, so definitely leave comments. I always like hearing your guys' solutions about how you think I can solve puzzles. Oh wait, someone said that this was a multiple part puzzle. There we go. Really? Okay, let's just go in here right now. Oh, motherfucker. Okay, I get it. I have to throw it. So, I was just thinking, like, I love hearing your guys' comments about stuff, and then I realized, oh yeah, comments about this teleporter being even having more shit in it. Pa-ching! Teleporter took me to a place surrounded by teleporters. Okay. Where did this take me now? Here... Even the winds are guided by him and them. Huh. Didn't this just take me to the same place again? I don't know what the purpose of this is. Does going to different teleporter spots take me to slightly different places, maybe? Yep. It doesn't seem to be possible to move fast enough to step anywhere besides the first one necessarily. I'm back where I was before, right? Yeah, I'm just back where I was before. Huh. So they're right, it's a multiple part puzzle and that there's more than one location that gets teleported, but I'm not sure if it goes anywhere else, unless I'm missing something. But either way, yeah, I think this is the end of the episode. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm gonna go put stuff in my stash. I'm sure you guys will yell at me for all the things I've missed, but whatever. I'm having fun, and that's the important thing. And you guys seem to be having fun, too, because this series is... It has quite the loyal following right now, and I'm very psyched about that. I think the series actually has a better following than my original Dark Souls 2 series did when it first came out, which is definitely something for me to be happy about. So yeah, I'm just gonna go stash my stuff. Like always, thanks for watching.